thinking of a cool intro.
Well, you're looking at another custom loop project, and this one has given me quite a number of issues before I've even started bending, by the way. So first off, this is just sagging like a mother, and it's because it's so heavy. So this is a block from Fantex. This is made especially for the 1080 Ti, and it weighs anywhere between 2 to 3 times what this card would weigh if it was just using the reference cooler. And that is basically creating a great deal of sag. I know you can't really tell now, it's not too bad anymore, but it needs to be raised about like that. And then it'll be nice and straight, flush with the case. So I'm hoping that some of these tubes will fix that. In the worst case, I'll put maybe some like rubber stoppers down here to help lift it up as well. And that's just because, again, it's really heavy. Also, this right here, I'd like you all to meet the bitch bend. That's right. There's just really nothing else to say about it. It took a long time to get right. And it's not because it was super technical with the turns, whatever. It's just because the turns were so freaking close together. This had to go from the CPU block to the graphics card block. And also, I guess you guys can see this one kind of going into motion. So this is the stent from the reservoir up to the back of the radiator. Now, there's not much room in this case. This is the Fractal Define C Tempered Glass Edition. I've got this little bend here that I cut down to size, so it's cut to length fine, to spec, but getting it back here is just near impossible. It's just because of how I decided to arrange this entire loop. So we've got the reservoir here, and we've got a couple fans up front with dust filters in between the chassis and the fans to kind of keep the dust out or mitigate the dust buildup, to say the least. And then we have the radiator up top, and we have some fans gonna be basically doing a pull config. And then we have one exhaust fan at the rear, which I will turn down to the lowest possible RPM to eliminate the negative air pressure buildup in the case. So we've got one of these ready to go. We've got the, I know the camera is refusing to focus on what is important right now. The next, what is this? What am I supposed to call this? What's the name of this thing right here? All right, so we got the fitting, right? We got the little G quarter inch fitting, and this is like supposed to be the cap or something? The cap? We're gonna go with the cap. Anyway, I got a cap on this end and a cap on this end, and we're gonna wedge it somewhere back here.
All right, get on back here.
The amount of precision involved with these custom loops, especially in cases that aren't technically custom loop friendly. And I will say that confidently about the Fractal Design Define C. Look, nothing wrong with this case. It's my favorite case. I said that in the last video, but it's just not the easiest thing to water cool. So I have no room to, like, no room at all. All right, let's plug in the 8-pin and the 6-pin VGA cables. Might as well do that now because they're not blocking the pipe running from the reservoir to the radiator. And now the last two bends are the one from the graphics card up to, I don't know, either the reservoir or the rad, and then the CPU block to whichever one we don't fill up first. Also, managed to kind of get the graphics card straight. So you're seeing some B-roll clips now of a relatively flat graphics card, at least consistent with the basement level. And I just managed to do this by cutting a few slots into the back of the grill over here. I have a video on this. It's not recommended for most people unless you're okay with cutting up your case. And if you do it wrong, you're gonna have just random holes in your grill. But if you can pull it off, especially with a heavy card like this, I think it's gonna look sweet. And if you have an open block and a custom loop, you can see the fluid kind of moving inside. It's just gonna be the icing on the cake for this build. So this right here is kind of the icon. I haven't talked about what fluid color I'm gonna put in here yet. It's gonna be a surprise for part two, but I think you're going to love it, and no, it's not what you think it's going to be. Okay, it's not gonna be white, okay? So you can, yeah, relax. All right, so it's super hot in this room now, and I'm gonna call it quits for this part of the Fractal Define C tempered glass build. I think that the next difficult step will be formulating some kind of run from the graphics card port on the right side to the reservoir. So that's what I decided to do. That way we can get fresh coolant from the radiator into the CPU block, even though technically once the loop equalizes, temperatures will be pretty much the same everywhere. It's just conventionally nice to have the radiator feed the CPU, and of course have the reservoir and pump feed the radiator. So this bend is gonna be a little tricky, not only because it's gonna be kind of like a 3-point turn in the same way this one was, actually only 2 points because it doesn't have to go backwards again. But this pipe is kind of in the way of this run. This is actually almost level with this pipe, and it's also about the same distance back from the front side of the case. So I'm not really sure how I'm gonna do this. I might put a 90 degree in here and have it kind of jet off this way, but I feel like that would look kind of silly. I'm not sure. And then keep in mind, we also have to have a run from the CPU up to this port on the radiator. Again, not really sure what we're gonna do there. Also, if you're wondering what these are, so this is kind of like my fill port, I guess, is what this is gonna be. Just a little cap here, nothing too fancy, and this is my drain port. I usually just take a funnel and just stick it under here and then just pop the cap and let it drain. Nothing too fancy. Not really much else I can do here because I did not remove the basement door, which I think was an accomplishment in and of itself because there's not much space in the Defined C. And that's just a compromise that I'm willing to make because I love the compact nature of the case, especially when you have a custom loop inside. So on this note, let me know what you think I should do for this. It's gotta go from here to here. Okay, that's the only rule, but I'm open to creative solutions. I don't care if you wanted to go over and through or, oh, that'd be really strange. But do keep in mind, we gotta have the run from here up to the radiator as well. It's gonna be pretty difficult, but look, it's gonna pay off. I'm going to end the video. Thanks for watching. This is just a typical weekend upload vlog, if you wanna call it that. I hope you enjoy the B-roll, the tech porn, and that truck is very loud. Give this video a thumbs up if you thought it was cool. Be sure to subscribe for more content like this. This is Science Studio. Thanks for building with us.